My name is Kimberly Cunningham Summerfield. I am Chalagi and culturally Miwok. I was raised around here in on Tuolumne Rancheria. And I am an Indian cultural park interpretive ranger.
Earth into the sky.
With her colleagues, senior cultural demonstrator Julia Parker and cultural demonstrator Phil Johnson, Cunningham Summerfield demonstrates the cultural practices of Yosemite Valley's original people, the Awanichi. They gather their materials locally, but for the past 10 years, Cunningham Summerfield and many others have been concerned about the smothering blackberry and encroaching trees, strangling a wetland area she and the Awanichi ancestors used to gather native plants. The National Park Service has shared this concern and the dream of restoring native plants to the Meadow. With support from the Yosemite Fund, this dream is coming true. For years, non-native Himalaya blackberry has spread and dominated native vegetation. Restoring native plants is a priority. But what's the best way to get rid of blackberry?
My name is Brent Johnson. I work with resources management and science in Yosemite National Park, and I'm a botanist. One of the things that really inspired this whole project in recent years is work that's been done by Yosemite Institute. They started pulling blackberry out several years ago, and what we saw was when they removed the blackberry, you could see plants that had been buried underneath it for several, maybe decades, came back, and you could see dogbane coming back the next year, and the blackberry not doing so well. So it was really inspiring to see, just by removing the blackberry and not having to do any seeding or restoration other than getting rid of the blackberry, we're getting really positive results.
With a grant from the Yosemite Fund, Johnson has designed an experiment testing ways to eradicate Himalaya blackberry. His comparative experiment includes ripping out and burning plots of blackberry.
So what we've done is we put in 10 plots that we can look at the native species when you burn an area, comparing it with areas where you've mechanically removed blackberry, just to see how fire will affect the native species when underneath the blackberry.
There's a couple of objectives here.
On October 21st, 2005, fire management scheduled a prescribed burn in the overrun meadow, a fire meant to accomplish many goals.
So one of the things that we're doing out here today is reintroducing fire, something that was important to the American Indians that lived here in the valley. And for hundreds, if not thousands of years, they were maintaining these gathering areas through the use of fire. And once Euro-Americans arrived, we started putting out those fires.
Without fire, things will overtake the meadows like it has been, and it may still is today. So the forests and the meadows, everything needs fire when it's done in a good way and in the right way.
It was an outstanding example of cooperation between the local Native American tribes and a national park. Cultural demonstrator Phil Johnson, Jay Johnson's son, agreed to ignite the prescribed fire by means of traditional techniques. Instead of using modern drip torches and fusees, they use friction and dry tinder. Tribal members added to the ceremonial ignition fire, then invited the rest of the group to contribute.
Thank you, June.
Thank you.
The method honored their cultural traditions and had an ecological benefit as well. It kept drip torch fuel out of the wetland.
We were pleased, we were happy that the Park Service did ask us if we wanted to be involved in this burn. And so we said yes, and the burn was done, and it was just unbelievable how things work so good. I think everybody was pleased to see us do this.
The ceremonial prescribed fire helped bring people together to restore natural and cultural resources in Yosemite Valley.
Again, I'd like to see the plants become healthy again, the earth breathe, the water return, the animals return, the memories and the practices return.